Health groups are demanding a ban on the importation and sale of all vaping products, except ones prescribed by a doctor. The Cancer Council says users as young as 12 are purchasing and becoming addicted to e-cigarettes. Emily Rice has this exclusive report.
Amy from Preston started using e-cigarettes 5 years ago, thinking it was less harmful than smoking. But the 39-year-old says she just replaced one bad habit with another.
Very addictive. I would say probably more addictive than cigarettes.
While Amy quit vaping in 2021, a new generation is adopting the habit.
Just everywhere, so many people.
In Australia, a prescription is required to purchase any nicotine vaping products, but other e-cigarettes, including lolly-flavoured vapes, can be sold to anyone over 18.
This is the Wild West. We have no idea what's in those products.
The Cancer Council is now calling on the federal government to ban the importation and sale of all e-cigarettes, including those sold in vape and convenience stores. The only exception, nicotine vapes prescribed by a doctor.
That's why we need to stop the importation of these unless they come with a valid prescription from a GP saying this is a product which is being used by a smoker to help quit.
A big concern is teenagers and children becoming addicted.
Kids as young as 12 calling the quit line.
But Brian Marlowe of Legalise Vaping says outlawing e-cigarettes altogether will only drive sales of the products underground.
No, prohibition has never worked historically, and it's not going to work this time if anti-vaping groups get their way.
No matter what happens with the vaping regulations, the one certainty is the expense. This pineapple ice device just set me back $30.
Don't touch it. Don't start.
Emily Rice, Nine News.